Yes, good morning students. How was your previous exercise? Yes, now let's move to our next exercise, that is 1.2. In that, what we will going to learn is that how to represent the root numbers on number lines. As you all did it, rational numbers, whole numbers, integer numbers, already you have denoted or locate that numbers on numbers line, na? But we didn't did how to locate the root numbers on number line. Now today we will going to learn that how to represent the root numbers on number line. Okay. Now see that you all know the Pythagoras theorem. What is the rule of the Pythagoras theorem? Is Pythagoras theorem says that when the right angle triangle we are having a right angle triangle ABC, and this is our base A, this is our perpendicular B, and this is the length, okay, C. So if we want to find the length C, what is the rule? C square should is equals to A square plus B square. Okay, this is our Pythagoras theorem and you all know that. Okay, now let's move how to represent the root numbers on number lines. See, students, just learn it, that how to represent root 2 on our number line. First of all, you have to make a number line, okay, of equal units. I have taken these units equally divided, all units now 0 1 2 3 4, this is divided into one unit, okay. It's up to you whether you want to divide it in centimeters, you can do it, or inches, you whatever you want, you can divide that. But remember it, that this distance should be equal, there should not be any of the other differences in the distances, okay. I have divided each of them in inches, so this is my 0 1 2 3 4, and so on. Now the first step is we have to find the root 2. How we will able to find that the distance between 0 and 1? We will going to make a one perpendicular line from 1. Perpendicular means 90 degree. Okay. How will you make 90 degree? As you all know how to make it with protractor as with compass as well. Or otherwise you can make it with protractor also. Na? Then put your protractor here at point B and make the 90 degree line. Okay. And name that point C. Which point C? The one unit distance you have to cut here also. That will be known as C. The same distance. How will you take one unit distance? You will keep your compass at point A and put your other point B. Okay, this is the one unit. So put your compass here and cut one unit distance here and make that point as C. Okay, now you got this and triangle ABC. You have got triangle ABC. Now by Pythagoras theorem, you all know that AC square should is equals to AB square plus BC square. Here I have written that only AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. So this is my one unit, this is my one unit. As you know that we have marked it as a one unit only, na? So AC square is equals to 2, AC is equals to root 2. So you have got AC is equals to root 2. Now you got that root 2, okay. Now how will you, we have to represent that root 2 on our, in our number line. So how will we represent that root 2 on our number line? Now we put our compass here at point A, and from A to putting our compass on A, and we will cut an arc from C. Okay, let's see where that arc will cut. This arc will cut at point P. We got a new point P. So this is our radius, this is also our radius. We know that AP is equals to AC, so AP is equals to root 2. We got root 2 on our number line very easily, you know. Same way we will proceed for root 3 also, na? Let's see how will we get root 3. You all are having your values of AC root 2. Now from C you can make one perpendicular, that is CD of one unit. Okay, you know how will you will be making this. Place your protector here, stretch 90 degree, and then place your compass and cut one unit arc to D. You got this one unit. Okay, this is CD. Now from how will you get root 3? You know that the triangle ACD. Now we will put our Pythagoras theorem same. Triangle ACD, AD square is equals to AC square plus CD square. We got AD is equals to root 3. AD we got root 3. Now to represent root 3 on our number line, put your compass on point A and then cut one arc from D to point wherever we got that point. We will be getting that point at point Q. So we will say now AQ is equals to root 3. Because this is our radius only, AD is equals to AQ. So AQ is also root 3. Now let's move further.